Have you ever wanted to add a video inside a HubSpot blog or a landing page? Well, now instead of using a third-party tool like Vimeo or YouTube or another service, you can do that right inside HubSpot.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
Having video inside HubSpot is a really powerful tool. So for starters, it's just like uploading a photo or a graphic for a blog post. It's right inside your file library, which makes it easy to not have to go find the URL and figure out how to embed it. It's right there inside HubSpot. Secondly, you get a chance to use that to enroll contacts in workflows. So for example, if a contact downloaded something and they watched part of your video, you can actually then use that watch behavior to then customize the actions that happen to that contact afterward. And then the third thing is, you not only get a comprehensive area for all of the video analytics to that specific page or that blog post, but you also see that video activity inside a contact record. So let's go ahead and show you how to set up video inside HubSpot and how to add it to a landing page or a blog. So right now we're looking at the landing page screen. I have a test page set up and we'll show you how to add that video right here inside of HubSpot. So I'm gonna open this test page. I used a template that had already been created, so it's already set up here. And when you add a video inside HubSpot, you're just adding it inside of a plain text field and you get a chance to embed it again, just like you would an image. So I'm gonna click into this. And if I were to add a video on this side, let's say I'm gonna replace this lorem ipsum and I click on insert video. I've got a couple of videos here to choose from. So these videos have already been loaded into my library. I'm gonna show you what it looks like in a different portal that hasn't yet enabled HubSpot video to make sure that we know what that looks like as well. So this is our test portal here. And you'll see if I go to embed a video into this test portal, click inside insert video, you'll get this screen that says, so again, depending on when you're watching this video, you may or may not get this screen or a different one, but you basically have to enable this and turn on the new features so that your videos then become a part of HubSpot instead of simply, you know, a third-party extension. So I turn on these features. This HubSpot video is actually powered by Vidyard. So there's some more capabilities here beyond what I'm gonna show you, but today we're just gonna talk about the very basic embedding capabilities based inside HubSpot. So if I were to click turn on new features, then what I would get is the ability for me to add video inside of my file library. So here you'll notice that I have added a onboarding with HubSpot Agency versus HubSpot. And this video, you'll see over here, this is what this video looks like. We uploaded it into that the file library. And then this little toggle button on and off means that this is what makes it possible to allow embedding, sharing, and tracking. So you can do this. We have, in the demo that I'm showing you here, we have Marketing Hub Professional, and you can do up to 250 videos. So again, depending on your level that you're paying for, you may find that there's gonna be limitations based on your subscription. So I can see, if I go into this video, I can see that it's used in one blog post. If this video was used, let's say, you know, five places on my website, it would show all the places here as well. So I'm gonna go back to that test page and I'm gonna select that video in particular. And you're gonna see that you see a preview here. And if I want to edit this, I would edit either the overlay. I can put in a custom call to action. So that might be that I want to have it say, I'm gonna create new. And inside this call to action, I get a button. So just like in other parts of your blog, you might actually have this be, you know, schedule a demo or I wanna learn more or whatever that happens to be. And so I'm gonna keep this just as a sample on new call to action and click next. I'd name my CTA, we're gonna name it test CTA. And here, when you're on a landing page, you don't want it to leave. You don't wanna leave and send them somewhere else. So let's say this is gonna be a meeting link. This is gonna be, you know, book a meeting. And I can choose whose meeting link. This is mine and my campaign. I'm gonna click save. So then I've got this as my call to action. I can insert that on top of that video and it's going to overlay after the video starts. If I select this here, it's before the video starts. And then we'll see what that looks like here shortly when I save it. We can also have a custom form appear inside the video. So that's another option. And then I'm actually gonna change this to overlay none because I just wanna show you what this looks like. And then for style, again, this is gonna be your player color, which is this little triangle button here, the width and the height. So this space is probably not 1900 by 1800. So I'm gonna go ahead and make this a little bit smaller so it doesn't break the screen. And I have this set to link together so the ratios stay proportionate. And I'm gonna click save. Now this is saved inside the template itself. If I click publish, I'm gonna publish now. And this is a test page. So it's gonna take me to the performance. It's gonna show me this specific page. Here's the preview of what that looks like. And inside this page, I've got this nice video. If I click into it.
We get questions all the time about HubSpot's onboarding services.
There we go. Tyler's telling us all about onboarding services. And you can see that this is a really great way for someone to become engaged with the content rather than just a picture. So videos are really exciting to add to that page here. In the future, when you go back to that page, when there's more people that have visited this, you'll be able to see the video analytics right here in this screen. And if contact had gone to this page and they actually had filled out this form and then went back to this page, you'll be able to see how much of this video that they watched, again, enroll them in custom workflows and so on and so forth. So that's how it works. If you go into then again, this library, this is the video that we had used. And for starters, you might wanna just go in and upload the videos that you know you're gonna be embedding in pages. These might be the consistent demos that you use. They might be overviews of specific product features, anything you'd wanna be putting into HubSpot on a regular basis. These also accompany specific permissions, so you do need to double check that with your team. And that's it. Go ahead and give HubSpot video a try and let us know what you think. For more HubSpot hacks, how-tos, and tips, hit that subscribe button. We have new videos coming at you each week. If you have questions or comments, go ahead and drop a comment below. We read each and every one, and we'll probably see it in a future video.